everyone, I'm Chef Marco, and today I'm going to introduce you to the bread world. And to start this, I'm going to show you how to do what for me is the easiest bread to possible to do. It's a recipe that is really, really easy to do, and is all the ingredients is something that you already have at home. Is just flour, yeast, and water. I'm just going to do it with a few different things. I'm going to add some nuts to it, some seeds, just to make it nice. But the base recipe is really simple, and is something that if you never bake a bread, if you never done a bread before in your life, you can start with that one because it's really, really easy to do. Baking bread is something that I really enjoy doing because for me it's very therapeutic and it's very relaxing to do it. I love to bake my own bread, and it's the bread that you bake at home is so much better than the bread you buy in the shops. It's a lot healthier for you as well, and it's so much better. It's something that you can bring your family together and bake the bread, put your kids helping out with the bread and doing it. And like I said, this bread that I'm doing now is really, really easy to do. We could do it just with the flour and the water. The only thing I want to do is just to add some more flavor to it. I'm going to use some walnuts and some pumpkin and sunflower seeds just to give some more flavor to the bread and to give some... it's just going to be different like that. So the first thing is we're going to need to put our yeast in the water to start to activate the yeast. I'm using some dry yeast. You can have fresh yeast, you can make your own yeast, but like I said, I'm showing you how to do the easiest way possible so you start baking your own bread. If you start it like that, then you can always go to change it fresh yeast and make your own yeast, but with this, it's really easy for you to start, and it's just really easy to do the bread. So literally just open the sachet and drop it in warm water. So while we wait our yeast to start activating in the water, we're gonna go ahead and add mix all our dry stuff. And our dry ingredients, I'm using some all-purpose flour or plain flour. Again, you can choose the types of flour, but I'm going for the basic. So just plain flour. And I'm gonna add my nuts and my seeds now to the flour. Okay, just add 10 grams of salt. And the ingredients for this bread, I'm gonna leave the recipe below, but it's 500 grams of flour, 300 grams of the water, warm water, and 7 grams of the yeast, and then whatever you wanna add. Okay, so as soon as you add your water to the flour, start mixing everything with a spoon, because if you put your fingers, it's gonna be too sticky, so it's easier if you start with a spoon until you can. You're gonna do it for like 2 minutes, then you're gonna put it in a surface, and you're gonna knead the dough with your hands for another 10 minutes. Okay, so dough is ready. I've been working it for more or less 10 minutes. You can see it's not sticky anymore, so it's a good thing. So we're just gonna put some oil into a bowl and just work it around. Okay, so we're gonna put it in a bowl. We're gonna cover it with a towel, and we're gonna let it prove for minimum 1 hour or until it's double in size. Okay, so it's been 45 minutes. I just changed the bowl of my bread. I put it in this, this is a bread bowl. It's something that you can buy and is really cheap. It's nice to mold the bread in the shape that you want, and it's nice to rest your bread. Just put quite a lot of flour in there, then put the bread. I'm gonna cover it again. So it's been 45 minutes, and now I'm gonna cover it for another half an hour. And this half an hour is the time you need to preheat your oven. Put your oven as the highest it can get, minus 250 degrees. I don't know how high your oven can go, but put the highest. So it's been 25 minutes in the oven. Now you're gonna need to take the lid out of the pan, and you're gonna take the lid out so that you give this nice crust on top, and you're gonna give the color to the bread. So the bread was in the oven in the pan with the lid for 25 minutes, and then I took the lid out and I cook it for an extra 15 minutes just so you get this color. As soon as you take the lid out, you're basically gonna bake the bread until it starts to see a nice color, and you're happy with the color because the bread was cooked already with the lid on the pan. You just take the lid so it gets this nice color on the bread. And now we take it out, put it on a rack. It's important to have the bread on a rack so the bread, the hair goes around the bread and doesn't make the bottom go soggy. So this is really important. And don't slice the bread straight away. Let the bread cool down a little bit and then slice it and enjoy. bread is delicious. And again, if you never bake a bread before, this is the best bread for you to start, because you're gonna see how easy it is, and you're gonna see that the flavor is nothing compared to the flavor of the bread you buy in the shop. So please give it a go, try this bread, because you're gonna love it. You're gonna start to like to bake bread, and from that bread you're gonna end up doing a lot more breads, because you're gonna see that it's actually really, really good. And it's amazing now on your breakfast, so tomorrow morning with a little bit of butter, perfect. It's the best way to start the day. Hope you enjoy the video. Don't forget to subscribe our channel, like our videos. My name is Marco, and I'm a private chef.